First of all, change is not in our hands. Allah, change is not in our hands, it's in Allah's hands. In Allah la yughayyiru ma biqawmin hatta yughayyiru ma bi anfusihim. In that ayah, even the famous ayah, no doubt it is Allah, He does not change the condition of whatever is afflicting a nation until they change what is within them, what is afflicting them on the inside, what's affecting them inside of themselves. Even in that ayah, Allah attributed change itself to Himself. Allah didn't say people will change things, Allah said He will change things for them. They just have to make a change inside of themselves. So that's really what I want to focus on. How is it that we can bring a change inside of ourselves? You know, the real battle all of us has is against our own self. Your worst enemy is like your best friend, it's yourself. No one else. No one knows you better than yourself. You know, if there's one person that knows all of your flaws, all of your weaknesses, all of the things you could be doing better, all the times you waste, all the things you shouldn't be involved in but you are anyway, all the bad habits you have, the ones that are known to others and the ones that are not known to others. If there's someone who knows that really, really, really well, it's you. It's you. And you have to learn, and I have to learn to be hard on myself. One has to be able to stop complaining about the world and start complaining about themselves. What is wrong? What am I doing wrong? What are my shortcomings? What are the things that I look at myself and I say, what, if there were four or five things I could change about myself, if I could just do four or five things differently, what would they be? What would those things be that I wish I changed? What are the some things I wanted to accomplish last year and I never got to? I really wanted to though. I wanted to memorize like two more surahs. I wanted to study something. I want to finish reading that book. I never got around to it. But I really wanted to do it. What is keeping us from making those changes? That's the real like bit of advice that I'll share with you what I do for myself. It works sometimes, it doesn't work other times. But I'm hoping inshallah you'll be better at it than I am, and we're all going to be making changes for the better in our own lives. How do I make more use of that day? How do I make it more productive? That one day. You can fix one day, you fix your whole life. If you made one change to today, that means you've made that change for the rest of your life. For you, many of you, it's like weekdays and weekends. Your weekends are the same way every time. Your weekdays are the same way every time, right? Fix your weekdays. This time is for Salat. Right after that, there's this time for Quran. There's this time for me to learn something. There's this time for me to, you know, get my homework done or whatever it may be. Discipline your life. Make that change in your life. You know what else people fail to do? That's coupled with that. That's most common, and I personally have trouble with that also. And it's one of the hardest things to do is to maintain balance in your life. To maintain balance. Because we're pulled in many different directions. Our parents want our time. Our husbands and wives want their time. Our children want their time. Our career wants its time. Our friends want their time. Our masjid wants its time. Ourselves, we want to just be left alone. We need some time to ourselves. We have all these different pulls, right? And it's really important that we maintain a balance between all of these different poles. And a lot of times, we fail to do it. And when we do, we end up wronging one thing or another. This is the biggest change you can bring in your life to create balance. There are people who give their wife a lot of time and their parents no time at all. There are people who give their parents a lot of time and they spend no time with their wife.